An important aspect of scientific writing is voice, which is the unique manner in which an author puts words together and which reflects their particular view of the world. We all know writers with weak voices. Their writing is verbose or flowery or pompous. They ramble and never seem to get to the point. They use a lot of jargon and run-on sentences that must be read several times to understand. Their papers fail to appeal to the reader. We also know writers with strong voices. Their writing is clear and concise, even elegant. They don't waste the reader's time with meaningless digressions or extraneous information. We enjoy reading their papers. Developing a strong voice means paying attention to how you use language to convey your information. Doing so takes time and work, but is worth it in my opinion. Unfortunately, this aspect of writing is often ignored by scientists, mainly because modern scientific writing is designed to strip out anything that indicates a human wrote it. The reason is usually because the scientist author is trying to sound scholarly and unbiased. But the end result can sound flat, robotic, boring, or pedestrian. Alternatively, the scientific writer's voice can be honed to sound stimulating, authoritative, logical, or thought-provoking. In fact, it can be used to distinguish you from the crowd. Let me give you an example of two different voices. This writer has a voice that is trying to impress rather than communicate. It is an example of taking a small idea and dressing it up with big words. Here is an alternative wording. This translation conveys a completely different voice. It describes a geological formation in everyday language that is comprehensible even to a non-specialist. The clear language and lack of jargon indicate a voice that is concerned with communicating rather than impressing others with their erudition. This example shows how a writer's voice is affected by diction, that is, choice of words, and syntax, how those words are strung together. When I wrote my first papers, I was not thinking about developing a unique voice or writing style. I emulated the style of scientific writers I admired, which helped me write, but made my papers sound like someone else's. With time and experience, though, I developed my writing voice, one that reflects my distinct choice of words and how I use language to express myself. By the way, when my writing voice started emerging was when I began enjoying the process of writing. But how do you develop a strong voice, especially your own unique voice? Well, a good place to begin is to silence your internal critic, that little voice in your head that critiques everything you write as you write it. That was my problem when I first tried to write. Trying to write each sentence perfectly will inhibit your naturally spontaneous flow of words. Eventually, I learned to get my ideas down first and then later edit for grammar and punctuation. Next, I made a conscious choice about what I wanted my voice to convey to the reader. I decided that I wanted to be a writer who explained research findings clearly and logically and avoided confusing, ambiguous language. That choice led me to make a conscious effort to write with cohesion and coherence without being pedantic and boring. As I worked on my diction and syntax to meet this goal, my voice strengthened. Also, although my writing voice has been shaped by those early choices, it continues to evolve. For example, in later years, I've tried to write papers that more clearly explain the limitations of my studies or that offer alternative interpretations of my findings. That choice relates more to content than to language choices, but still impacts my voice. You may make different choices based on your particular writing goals and skill level. For example, some authors might want to write papers that sound more authoritative with a deep understanding of a topic. Others may wish to use more vivid descriptions to pull the reader into their research world. Still others may want to use more direct and spare language and avoid wishy-washy terms or jargon. If you are not yet certain what aspects of your writing voice you wish to develop, it helps to read other papers and to pay particular attention to the author's voice. If you find one that makes you say, "I want to sound like this author," then carefully analyze what it is that makes you admire their writing. Then use those insights to guide your writing. To recognize what your scientific writing voice sounds like to a reader, you want to read your papers out loud. Just hearing it in your head is not the same thing. Reading aloud will not only help you strengthen your writing voice, it will help you identify awkward or confusing sentences. Don't get discouraged as you work toward developing your writing voice. It took me quite a few years of writing and reading the literature before my true voice emerged. Thanks for listening, and if you have a question about developing your writer's voice, please leave a comment.